What's up, guys? Good morning. Wow, this is terrible lighting. Let me try over this way. There we go. Don't pay any attention to my old style wood cabinets. I rent this place, so I'm not doing anything to it. I just got a waffle maker. I love my mini pancake maker, but I'll be honest, I'm impatient and I don't like waiting for the mini pancakes to cook. So I got this gigantic waffle maker. And I'm gonna make waffles for dinner tonight. So there's that also. But hi guys, thought I would share that with you. On my agenda for today, today is my off day, it is Sunday. I slept hard last night. I have got to do some work on my car. So I had a bunch of like carbon fiber stuff that I put on the inside, and it's got like that self-adhesive on the back, and it's just started lifting. I can't get it to stay down. It's been super annoying. So I took some of it off last night. Like, I took the center console, what I had around the gear shift, and what I had on the dashboard off. And then the handle on my glove box that I had covered has like started lifting also, so I've got to take it off today. I worked on it a little yesterday and put Goo Gone on it, but it needs more than that. It's gonna take more time, and I just didn't feel like doing it all yesterday. So I've got to do that today. But yeah, other than that, it's gonna be a pretty relaxing day for me today. Probably gonna drink my coffee here in just a moment, chill out for a little bit, and then I'll get up and I'll try to start working on my car. That way I can go ahead and get it done. It's still kind of hot outside. It feels really humid out there right now, so I'm probably gonna be sweating a lot. I'll end up coming back in, I'm guessing, taking a shower and chilling out for the rest of the day. So that is pretty much what's on my agenda for today. I've got a load of clothes in the laundry washing, and yeah, yesterday was busy, but I cleaned my fish tank out. Let me show you guys. And redid it. That's Axel. These little bubbles are supposed to be good for betta fish, but yeah. He did have a brother. He did have Rex, and there was a split right here. But Rex ended up getting, what is it called? Like, is it water liver or something like that? He couldn't sink down. He kept floating to the top. I was told to try to give him a pee, like some of a pee, and put him in a different container and keep him pushed down. I did that. Nothing worked, and he ended up passing away. So now Axel gets the whole tank to himself. So yeah, guys. And I've had these fish for like 3 years. It sucks really bad. But anyway, all right, guys. So yeah, that's it for this morning. I'll check back in with you in a bit. All right, guys. So, oops, sorry. Jeez. I just got finished watching a movie. Wasn't that great, so I'm not even going to talk about it. You guys always get me, like, at my worst because I start filming on Sundays and I'm off on Sundays, so this is what I look like. Sundays are my rest days. I try my best not to do that much on Sundays so I can really give myself the time that I need because I think rest and recovery is extremely important. I also think it's best for my mental health, to be honest, because I'm constantly on this all day long, whether it's working with online clients, answering questions from in-person clients, like, it's part of my job. And watching movies and stuff and kind of taking some downtime and not doing anything, is really valuable to me. And a lot of my friends are like, you never go out and do anything. And, you know, we invite you, but you never come. And, you know, here's the thing. If I want to do it, I'll go do it. But if I don't want to do it, I have no problem these days saying no. Because my time is valuable to me and, I like my time. I like my off days. I like my days where I do as little as possible because most of the time throughout the week, I'm doing a lot. So even though today, I did go out, I did get a lot of that like adhesive stuff off. There's still some that's on there, but I'm gonna try to get some more off later on. Man, that some of that shit sticks and some of it just doesn't. Like, I don't know. It's just weird. But my new stuff will be here Tuesday. So I'm going to get that put on Tuesday. Yeah. And I paid my cleaning lady, Linda, to do some of my clothes from last week because I was gone. So I only had a small load of laundry to do, so I've got that done. I just have to go fold it. And then the rest of the day, I'm going to shower, and I'm going to come back down, and I'm going to watch a movie. And that's how I love to spend my Sundays. And most of the time, if someone asks me to do something on a Sunday, I'm not going to do it because, like, this is my time, and that's important to me. And if I'm going to be my best for everyone else, I need to take the time for myself. Man, my O-ring light just went off. I just charged this thing. I wonder if I can turn my flashlight on. I have another O-ring, but I just don't want to get it set up. I'll be honest with you. I just don't want to do it. Whoa. Holy. Wow. It's bright. We're going to go with it, though. Jeez. All right. So, I want to go over my supplements, what I'm currently taking, and also kind of like let you guys know, what, like some of the stuff that I take at home and some of the stuff I have at my studio. So the first thing I'm going to get started with is my morning routine. And these are my morning routine staples. You saw that this morning. Let me kind of turn these all facing one another. So I take daily reds, daily blues, and daily greens all from Zhou Nutrition, Zhou. So They just started coming out with these separately. They also have a deep greens. I took the deep greens for a long time, and when they came out with the dailies, I started taking it. I really believe in this. It really seems to help my digestion. So I take these every single morning. Along with that, I take an apple cider vinegar shot. I do the one you can get off Amazon that's got the apple cider vinegar, the lemon, and the cayenne pepper, or the honey and the cayenne pepper. So I do that shot in the morning. I'm not going to get it out because I have it in a jug, so I poured it out of the bottle into that container. I also do, this is called Pure Black. She Legit. I think some people call it She Legit. Anyway, this stuff is a, it's got like 80 of your 88 minerals that you need, and it is literally black. See that? And you have to kind of scoop it out with this and hang it on the side. Now, this stuff is expensive. This was about 90 bucks, but I've had this for like, this is my third month now, and I'm nowhere being finished with it. So what you do, or at least what I do, after I drink my ACV shot out of my little shot glass, I fill my shot glass up with water, and then this has lines on it. Wish this would focus so you could see. So you can see kind of the lines on that. And I literally only go to, what is that? I usually go to like the 0.25 mark. You hang it on the side of the glass and it seeps down into the water, and then you drink the water. Now, some people do larger than that. I don't feel like I need any more than that, so I do that because I do take a multivitamin also. But I also take silver. So this is the silver that I take. I take one dropper a day. There you go. I take one dropper a day. So this is to help with immunity. This is for minerals. So this is pure gold, silver, and I do that in the morning along with my ACV shot. Now in my coffee in the morning, I do collagen, again from Zhao. So I do one scoop of collagen, and then I have used, I don't know if it's called Sheik or Shehike, or Shike, but I've literally used this since 2017. I do one scoop of coffee in my coffee, and I love it. Now, contest prep this year, I did two scoops in the morning with my cream of rice, and that was my meal one. But now I'm just doing one scoop in my collagen, and then I'm having my other food for my meal. So, Shehike, I don't have a discount code or anything like that. I should probably contact them because I have this stuff on auto ship, and I'm not kidding, I've used it since 2017. Along with the Zhao stuff. So I started using, I don't have it with me. I took up my last bottle, but I started using Zhao Hair Fluence back in 2017 as well. And then in 2018, I noticed there was a sale on collagen. So I ended up getting four containers, and I just was like, man, where have I seen this logo before? I know I've seen this logo before. And I was taking my Hair Fluence, and I was like, oh my God, they're the same company. And I really loved their products. I ended up trying a couple of other products. So I reached out to them and said, hi, I use your products all the time. Are you guys looking for athletes? I'm really looking to become an athlete. And they said, you know, what is it exactly that you're looking for? And I said, just a sponsorship with supplements. I love your products. I believe in them. I have clients I can offer them to. I also have connections within Nutrition Factory in Tennessee, and I could probably help you get into there. And I did all of that. And this company really is a company that I believe in. All of their products are all natural. It's made in America, made in Utah. And I just really love this company. Like, they're actually affordable brands that offer quality products that I have no guilt about recommending to my clients because I know they truly work. And I'm not about to recommend something to my clients that is just some sort of fad bullshit. I'm just not going to do it. So that's how I got connected with Zhao. Anyway, that's that. Post-workouts, I've been using Leanway. So guys, look, I have a really difficult time with protein powders. For one, I'm allergic to eggs, so I have to have something that is not eggs, that doesn't have egg albumin in it, or is not processed in a plant with eggs, because I've had cross-contamination before with products, and it's not been a great outcome. So Leanway, I never have an issue with. There's also another brand that I use. I don't have it. At night, I'm about to start drinking their casein, but it is NutriCost. It just comes in a plain white with blue lid, and you can find that on my Amazon storefront. Leanway, really love this stuff. Also, this flavor, the caramel coconut, I swear it makes the best protein ice cream. And you can put just about any flavor of like sugar-free pudding mix or sugar-free syrups, and it tastes delicious. So there's that. Back on to supplements. I'm gonna go over my pre-workout kind of mix. Oh, I forgot to say, BCAAs. Okay. I know a lot of people drink this intra-workout, post-workout, or during the day. I take my scoop with this. So this is my combo that I take in the morning. So the reason that I take my BCAAs with my reds, blues, and greens is because it's got glutamine in it, and glutamine is good for gut health. So everything I do in the morning is centered around gut health with my ACV shot, my reds, greens, and blues, and my BCAAs with my glutamine in it. So that's my morning mix pre-workout. So Zao creatine, and I don't have it with me. They do have a pre-workout called Light Up Extra that's only got 100 milligrams of caffeine in it. I don't have it with me because I took it to my studio yesterday, because when I'm at my studio, I use the creatine, the Light Up Extra, and I use a pump product, and that's my pre-workout. So at home, what I have is my creatine, and then I also have Mr. Hyde. That's what I use for my stimulant. And I use Fulez because my boyfriend loves this product. So this is what I use for my pump. So I do one scoop, one scoop, one scoop. I'm a big believer in creatine. So that's my pre-workout stack. Now, my supplements that I just take on a normal basis, I take Daily Boost, I take zinc for immunity, I wish this would focus, I take thyroid support, and let me finish with the Zhao products. I take Gut Guru. I usually only do, after a show, I'll do two bottles of this and then I'm done. This is my second bottle I'm on. So once I'm done with this, I won't take it again until next year, unless I feel like I'm having some gut issues. And then I take DIM. Now, Zhao used to have a DHEA product. I really wish they still did. I wish they had not gotten rid of it. I put in my order once with my contact at Zhao, and she told me that they stopped making it, which was like heartbreaking because I loved it. So you can find this on my Amazon storefront also. Gosh, come on. So I take one capsule of DHEA. So those are my current off-season products. Look, if you want to try any of Zhao's products and you're not quite sure what you need to get to help you, please message me. I'll help you figure it out. Or go take a look at their website. Everything's got a detailed breakdown. There's tons of products that they have for just about anything. Men, women, overall health, like everything. So go check them out. A couple of other things that I take from Zhao that I don't have with me, I just had to place an order, so it got shipped, so I'll probably get it sometime this week, is I do take their K2 D3, the vitamin C, Elder Immune. Yeah, that's what I take, those three. So I get them in gummy form. The K2 D3 you can get in pill form, but I like the gummies. They're like a little treat. So Zhao, you can use my code CBurks20. It's in the description box below. Anything else you can find on my Amazon storefront. Again, this is my off-season stack. And to be honest with you, from off-season to on-season, it doesn't really change that much. I may take more of their, like, green tea, energy and focus, stuff like that. But everything pretty much almost stays exactly the same. So please check them out. Use my code. I don't get a kickback from it. It just lets them know that I am still valuable to be an athlete with them. So again, they're all natural products made in the USA, made out in Utah. I really believe in this company. It's not like a super huge company. So please check them out. They deserve more hype than what they actually get. So, all right, guys, I will check back in with you later. Thanks so much for watching. I'll probably see you guys tomorrow. What's up, guys? I am wrecked. I just went through my closet and tried to, like, get rid of some stuff because I just have a ridiculous amount of things and it's not cool. So, I've been meaning to do this. I've just been putting it off because I just haven't felt like doing it. But when you can literally not fit another shirt in your closet, how stupid is that? And that was just my closet. Like, I haven't even gone through my drawers for, like, gym stuff. So, yeah, there's that. But I thought a cool thing to do would be a what's in my gym bag type of deal. So, I'm gonna sit in the floor and fix this. Oh. That's a mirror back there, if you can't tell. Here comes Buffy. She's been sick. I think I told you guys that last week. She's just now gotten to where when she eats something, she doesn't throw up. Yeah. And then here's Jealousy. Kitty coming in. So let me kind of fix this a little better. Okay, there we go. Are y'all just gonna sit here with me while I do this? Okay. Okay. So, stop. Okay, so this is my current gym bag. Okay. It's just a canvas bag that I got off of Amazon. I just looked for like a duffel bag. And I wanted like leopard print or cheetah print. Obviously, I like it. You can tell. So, what is this? The Moment is what it's called. So, I'll try to link it in my Amazon storefront. Honestly, it's really great because the canvas is like super sturdy. It's lined on the inside. It's got a lot of room in it. It also has a place down here for shoes, but I don't use that. I just use it kind of like for extra storage. And it's got an outside zipper. So, first thing in my outside zipper, I have a little emergency kit with Band-Aids and stuff like that. Also have goodies powder in here, Schneider Electric container. I used to work for Schneider Electric, so there's that. I have headphones. These are not any kind of name brand headphones. I don't spend money on that because, to be honest with you, I usually only wear them while I'm doing cardio. I don't wear them while I'm training. I've just kind of gotten out of the habit of doing that. And if I train at my studio, I just blast music at my studio. I don't even know what brand this is. Rose? R-O-H-S. Again, just an Amazon find. I do have this, however. So, this is a Gym Buddy. Focus. They don't make these like this anymore, but this is so cool because you can just put it on a piece of machine, put your phone on it, and record yourself. And then I got this little clasp because I hated having the magnets inside my phone cover. So I got this little clasp that will just clasp on the outside of your phone, and you can stick your phone on it. Boom. There you go. Record yourself. So there's that. That's an outside zipper. I don't think I have anything inside here. Mm-mm. Usually when I'm heading into the gym, though, I am wearing sunglasses, so I usually just pop my sunglasses right here, and I'll hook my keys on the outside of here. So, getting into the guts of the gym bag, I have VersaGrips. I love VersaGrips. They're amazing. I also have my Cardillo weight belt that I customized myself. Just kidding, this way. I've got 4 Cardillo weight belts, okay? This one, I just got a plain pink one, and then I wanted to put rhinestones on it, so that's what I did. I have 2 knee guards. They are reversible. You guys know my knee started doing this weird stuff this year, but it's gotten better, but I just keep these in here in case I do feel like I just need to put them on. I have another pair of VersaGrips. Again, I love animal print. So that's animal print. And another pair of VersaGrips. I feel like you can never have enough VersaGrips, obviously. I have a band. This one is a rubber one to use if I need to. I also have a small loop band for glutes. I wondered where these were. I do have big headphones. Again, these aren't any kind of name brand. I used to have Beats, but honestly, I just got tired of wearing them. And I kept dropping them and all kinds of stuff. And I was like, they're going to break. I'm not going to spend money on this. This is the brand, again, off of Amazon. Focus. Focus, focus, focus. They're actually really good. A scrunchie in case I need it. Salon paws in case I need it. I think this is my business card holder that has no business cards in it. this is my plethora of just like, I've got another band in here. I've got more bands in here. I have my elbow brace in here. And I have my bands that I use for cable kickbacks. Or not my band, but my straps that I use for cable kickbacks that wraps around my foot. Because my gym does not have them. I also have another arm brace that goes this way. If you can't tell, I've had issues with injuries. Another arm support. These are pretty awesome. Oh my gosh, this has faded so much. This used to be pink and blue. It's like green and orange now. anyway, these are really cool. If you need like some at-home stuff, this is awesome. What you do, let me turn this down. You wrap it around your toe here. Okay, put it around your knee here. Go down like this. Oh, I'm sorry. Around your opposite knee. And you kick back. They're actually really awesome. I used these for a long time in the studio when I didn't have a cable machine. Super, super great. Awesome for travel. Again, if you have an at-home gym and you don't have a cable machine, these are wonderful. They should be on my Amazon storefront also. I'll make sure I go back and look today and add everything, but yeah. Really cool. So I only have one cable attachment. So I got these and then I thought I had lost my other ones and then I ended up finding them. So I obviously have a bunch of cable attachment stuff. I have my towel from the Eastern European Amateur Olympia just in case I need it. Another pair of VersaGrips. Don't hate on me for my VersaGrip problem, okay? Wrist wraps from Better Bodies. The Glutezilla. Okay. You can find this on, what is this? X Bands, I think is what it's called. But premise is you put your feet in these straps, wrap these around your thighs, and you can glute thrust, and it gives you extra support. So I just keep this with me, again, in case I want to add it to any exercises. And then last two things, another set of booty bands, obviously, again, animal print, and then a long set of bands. So the long ones. What's up, guys? I am just filming this outro. It is Sunday, the day after the Olympia. What is today's date? The 5th. And I didn't get a whole lot of content this week. I just had a lot going on. Was super busy with some things, so I just did the best I could. But I did check-ins. You guys saw that. Ryan and I kind of spoke a little bit about it. He says, you know, let's not change anything. Let's just kind of keep everything the same. But I'm starting to feel really kind of like bloated in my midsection. My midsection is not staying as tight as I would like for it to be, even though you can't tell in video, but when I'm looking in the mirror, like, I do still have like a little four pack going on, but my lower abdominal wall gets distended more and more throughout the day because I'm eating so much. So I think tomorrow I'm just gonna slightly cut back on a few things. I am in a really good spot. I am maintaining between 144 and 145, which is pretty normal for an off season for me. However, I will say that my shape and my muscle tone going into this off season is different than it has ever been before, even last year. So I am really happy with things on that aspect and that side of everything. I think I just kind of need to keep pushing in this direction, but I do kind of want to pull back just a little bit, or maybe just switch out some of the foods that I'm eating and see if that affects the lower distension that I'm having. It's not like that during the morning. It's just kind of like as the day goes on, because I am eating a lot of food, you know, your belly kind of blows out a little bit. But I want to try to mitigate that as much as possible. I am trying to have a smaller waist, so we'll see. One thing I have failed at doing is vacuums. I'm just not consistent with it at all. So I'm about to start setting serious timers on my phone. I had timers set, but I was always doing something when the timers would go off. So I just kind of need to make a habit of doing this, like, the minute that I wake up, go to the bathroom, take the dogs out, come in, do the vacuums. So I'm going to try to start that this week.
Sorry.
Time changed. I hate time change. I thought they were doing away with it, but here we are yet with another time change that's just going to screw everyone up for 3 months before we go back. Thoughts on the Olympia. So I'm just going to give you my thoughts on the women's aspect of things. So women's bodybuilding, Andrea Shaw won again. Beautiful. I think she'll win five more. Like, she looks great. The second place finisher, I forget her name, but she looks amazing. I mean, she's definitely pushing Andrea, so, you know, go for Andrea to have, like, a little bit of competition going on there. Fitness, I'll be honest, I'm so sad about fitness. I love Missy Trescott. her physique is just out of this world, right? She ended up getting injured like literally 15 seconds into her performance, right? And that sucks. And then Whitney Jones got injured. So Oksana Kucina won fitness. Look, here's the thing. Oksana always has like an amazing routine and stuff, which bumps her up because in fitness, the physique round is only 1/3. Your fitness round is 2/3. I'm telling you, I think Missy would have taken it hands down. There would have been no question. Like, this was definitely her show to lose. And unfortunately, I wouldn't say that she lost. An injury put her out and she just didn't finish, which sucks because that woman's insane. Figure Sydney Gillen won again with Jessica Reyes Padilla coming in second, which I think is really cool because more and more you're seeing more and more women over the age of 35 and 40 like just place higher and higher and higher in some of these shows. And I think it's really great to see women who are over the age of 40 just excelling and continuing to excel. I think it's awesome, and I think it can only do good things for the sport. Jessica Reyes looked phenomenal. Sydney's like shape is hard to beat. So Sydney, this was her 7th win. And unless somebody comes along that looks similar to her that can do a little bit better, I don't see her losing anytime soon. Women's physique, Sarah Villegas, I think that's how you say her name, retook her title. She looked phenomenal. Natalia Coelho took second, who was your past year's Olympian. I really like Natalia. I worked a booth with her once. She was at the Olympia before she had switched to women's physique. And she's just so sweet, so nice, like just wanting to like do her best and give back to the sport. I've also met her at workshops. So I'm a little bit biased there, I'll be honest. But Sarah's hard to beat from the back. Like, her shape and conditioning and structure from the back is just insane. So, you know, it's a toss of the coin on that one. What else do we have? I think the only thing that's left is bikini. So last night, Jen Dory took over her title once more. She had won in 2021. Maureen won in 2022. I'll be honest, I had Maureen winning this one, only because Maureen's like fullness and flow and shape, I preferred it, right? But here's the thing, I also prefer a more muscular bikini look, so I wouldn't have been sad if Ashley would have taken it. I wouldn't have been sad if Laura Lee would have taken it. I've worked with Ashley and Laura Lee and Maureen and Jen at the women's, the National Women's Workshop. They're all really nice. I worked with Maureen the most, so maybe I'm a little bit biased. She was just super nice and super grateful, but Jen looked really good, and she did bring that mix of, you know, her fullness from when she won, but her conditioning of last year, so she kind of met them in the middle, and it got her the win, so congratulations to her. It was a great Olympia all in all. Like, there were some really good contenders in each category and in the men's categories. I watched the men also. So, yeah, I love bodybuilding. So, anyway, guys, I am going to try to get a full day of eating for you in this next week's video. That's what's coming up there. And then the following week is going to be Thanksgiving. So you guys will come along with me for that, and I'll probably just do that on my phone because I don't feel like taking my computer to edit stuff and all that jazz. But anyway, guys, thanks so much for watching and coming along with me throughout my off-season journey. Like I said, I don't have plans to compete until July. I plan on doing Universe. But who knows? That could change. Especially with how good I'm feeling about some of the density that I've been able to put on in the past 8 weeks. So, who knows? If I have another good 8 weeks, you might see me sooner rather than later. But finances will determine that also. So, anyway, guys, I hope you're having a great day. I hope you had a great week. Make good choices. Hug a dog. Kiss a dog. Love on some animals. They will make you feel better. I love her. All right, guys. Have a good one.